Well, Islanders fans have been well aware of the storyline of Matt Barzal to start this season, and they've been excited watching him continue to develop and gain confidence, knowing he could be a big part of this team this season and moving forward. On the Vancouver side, they understand that feeling because they have a player by the name of Brock Besser who's really been shining in Vancouver this season.
Couldn't do it. Brendan Gaunce worked it around for Tanev. For Tanev in the high slot, they sail it across instead for Hutton, snapping one through a screen from Grantland, bumbled, but eventually held onto by Yaroslav Halak in the first 90 seconds. Around the Islanders' goal, threw it up the wall, kept in by Henriksson, then Louis Eriksson turned one towards the net, and another glove save there from Halak. Pushed ahead, and it is Ladd and Barzal with a two-on-one. Ladd across, Barzal loads, and the shot was blocked by Tanev. Ahead for Hossang, cutting in. Delzato trying to catch him. Hossang to the outside. Put it back in front, or trying to, with Nilsson down and out. And Hossang couldn't get it into the crease. Just tested it out there while we were showing you some replays. And gets back on the ice. And here is Andrew Ladd on a shorthanded breakaway. Ladd in alone. Scores! Andrew Ladd, shorthanded Islanders with a 1-0 lead.
Boy, is that any good. Andrew Ladd did a little bit of a break as that puck bounced over the Vancouver Canuck defenseman Hutton, and away Andrew Ladd goes.
For Andrew Ladd, who gets his sixth of the season in the process.
Well, last year, Andrew Ladd scored his first goal of the season against these Vancouver Canucks, as did Jason Chimera. So let's see what happens there.
Louis Eriksson back door and a tap in. Perfect setup, Thomas Vanek with the goal. And we're tied at one. Then down to the stick, merging ahead. It is Nilsson. Left side for Hickey with a shot, and Nilsson pushed it away. As this one comes on the stick of Jake Virtanen. Quick shot into Halak, who makes the save. Barzal won the race to pick up that puck again. Draws a penalty. And it's back out for Eberle. To the bench goes Halak. Eberle down the middle of the ice. The backhand punched away by the goaltender, and then the whistle comes on a high stick infraction, and it's Louis Eriksson down low into the skates. Bo Horvat's backhand just missed. Letty in with Boychuk. Delzato out of the box. Islanders without a shot on that power play, but they've got it, and it's Letty in the slot. He was caught from behind. He dished it off to Beauvillier, and Nilsson made the save. In the 1999 draft, he wears 22. Henrik was the third overall pick. He wears 33. Hossang across, DeHaan, a shot, he scores! Calvin DeHaan, it's 2-1 New York. As Boychuk walks in alone, all the way over for Barzal, then for Eberle, scores! They let Eberle walk down Main Street, Barzal found him and he fired it home.
Now it all starts really with a good chip in.
Lee to Barzal to Letty. Final 30 seconds of the period, all power play time. Letty and Barzal playing catch at the top. Now Bailey across for Barzal. Nilsson was moving. Barzal steps, shoots, save made, rebound alive, and Nilsson is able to reach out and cover with 19.1 showing. We're just onto the ice, DeHaan and Pelech in place of Boychuk and Letty. The Islanders have to find another way in. Pelech followed up, got it to Barzal with a step back across Stetcher, the backhand saved by Nilsson. Barzal right on his own rebound. Some disturbance. Bailey, Mayfield off the wall, back in front, loose puck, pushed away, they score! It came back to Anders Lee, and the Islanders add to their lead.
There's just a big, big hunger out there right now. There's a wounded duck, and the Islanders are all over him. They're just not giving the Vancouver Canucks any kind of time. Now he finds ways to use them.
There's Hossang dishing. Letty shoots. Save. Quine went digging and couldn't nudge it past Nilsson. 70 games in the National Hockey League after having you as the head coach in both junior and in the American Hockey League, as Horvat rips one past the blocker of Halak, and Bo Horvat has made it 4-2.
That's another shorthanded goal that the Islanders have given up. The good, smart decisions at the blue line.
Stetcher's shot is held on to by Halak. Had a roll off his stick. Lee on the retrieval. Tavares out in front of the goal. Bailey worked it quickly. Letty shot off the glove of Nilsson, and then it lands on the top of the Canucks goal.
To Lee, legal. Nice back to Bailey, and there's the one-timer, and Nielsen's able to get just a little bit of that glove, and very fortunate that puck didn't go into the net. Letty lets go a real hard shot. Puck's bouncing, 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 and about 6 inches too high.
Lee chipped ahead. Barzal will use the glove to settle it down. He's got Ladd with him. Got it across. Ladd back in front, and a sliding Tanev got in the way. Bo Horvat out of the corner, right in front for Hutton again. And it rolled wide of the goal. Up with it is Bailey Lee. Everly spinning with it. Leaves it for Mayfield down the wall. Scott Mayfield gets it on the forehand. Drives it hard to the goal line.
Line.
Chip to the front. Hosang worked it back to Hickey with a shot kicked away by Nielsen.
Real good game for Josh Hosang up to this point in time.
Chimera forced Stetcher off the puck. Beauvillier got wrapped up but still able to play it. And then Chimera for Pelik, a wrist shot. And Nielsen came out from that pile up in front of the goal and snagged that one with the glove hand.
And that's always a good thing. If you see something working, there's no reason why the vets can't continue to do that.
Quick shot and a glove save from Halak on Delzato.
Best save of the night.
Came off the wall for Pouliot, nudged on, and it's Berchi and Besser. Besser from the outside, fired it high, kicks off the glass and back out of the zone.
A lot of different elements to their game.
Two on one, Tavares and Lee. Tavares to Lee, he shot it wide. Nearly Anders Lee's second of the night. It stays 4-2 for the moment as Henrik Sedin comes after this miscue. Letterbuck spill to the ice, and now it's Sam Gagne. Gagne winds and fires. Granlund may have redirected that one. It continues all the way back. Pelik tried to snap one on for a breakaway try for Anders Lee. Pouliot got a piece of it. Lee in front. Tavares scores! Oh, what a play all the way around. Anders Lee and John Tavares. It's a three-goal lead for the Islanders.
And there's not many guys that can score in that tight and get it up that quickly.
I used to play with one. The guy's name was Ralph Backstrom for the Montreal Canadiens.
Edler's shot tipped a couple of times. Didn't miss the net by much. Islanders get on it, get it cleared. Skipping puck will force Nielsen to play it. The New York Islanders have gone the first 10 games at home this season without a regulation loss. Their win here tonight is their fourth in a row as Hutton's shot is fended off by Halak. And the New York Islanders have scored 5 goals for the 11th. Time this season and move into a tie for first place in the Metro Division.
Well,
24 games in, Butch.
Yeah, well, you know what I like about the Islanders is they're prepared to play. And, you know, they've got themselves on their toes. They're skating early on. Yeah, it was a little bit, but not a terribly slow start. Vancouver came out ready to go, but the Islanders have had really good first periods. And that just sets everything up for them, allows them to get into their flow, get into their style of play, allows Doug Weight to get everybody into the game. He likes that four-line rotation.